The threat letter was not sent to the churches. The threat letter was dropped at around the headquarters and was brought to me. I was the one that opened the envelope, read the threat letter. On seeing that, I now invited the Christian Association of Nigeria to tell them about the threat. Whether it is real or not, we have to be security conscious. So I gave them copies of the letter so that they will adjust their programs in the church. Instead of closing late, they should close on time. Thereabout, I now directed all my DPOs to ensure that every Friday, police patrol team must go to mosque and give them adequate security until they finish the Jumat prayers. Equally, on Sundays, all the patrol teams will go around the churches and ensure that they are safe, and after the church service, before they close. The threat, we don't take it lightly because you don't know who is behind it. And I've advised the Christian community to be peaceful. They should not bother. I'm on top of the situation. And I told them that if they notice anything, they should make sure they inform me immediately. And they themselves should have their security men to be on guard. If they see any suspicious movement, they should inform me. Because security is not just for the police, it's for everybody. So that's what I did. The letter came through me by investigating. I've directed my SIB to move in to see if we can unravel the circumstances beyond the letter. The DSS are equally working on, because I've informed all the security agencies, all, and we are all investigating to get to the root of the matter.